1914. During the death and destruction of World War I, a small band of brash young Americans helped save nearly 10 million civilians from starving to death behind German lines. They dropped everything, traveled thousands of miles, and went into the prison of German-occupied Belgium to do a job no one had ever done before. The youngest was only 19 years old. These unarmed warriors of the CRB had to overcome huge logistical challenges, international intrigues, and internal conflicts with their Belgian partners. They faced battle-hardened German officers and struggled to remain neutral as they watched civilians suffering under the harsh German rule. In the end, the CRB helped create the largest food relief program the world had ever seen. It's an incredible story few know about today. That's because of this man. A successful mining engineer started the CRB to tackle what had never been done before. Feed an entire nation trapped in the middle of a world war. By the end of the war, he was beloved in America and known around the world as the great humanitarian. His name was Herbert Hoover. Because of his presidency, the CRB has all but been forgotten, along with the individual stories of the young Yanks who worked in German-occupied Belgium. Their heroism, humanity, and self-sacrifice in helping others deserves to be told and remembered. Now, from the author of two Kirkus Reviews Best Books of the Year, comes the fascinating page-turning story. Written for those who love an inspiring true tale, Yanks Behind the Lines interweaves personal stories into a colorful tapestry of the CRB, the courageous delegates and their bold leader who achieved the impossible. They did what they did because it was the right thing, the ethical thing, to do. And in the process, they helped change the way the world saw America and how America saw itself. It's a story that every American should know.